40 here at Border Cricket Ground. Two to Boone, 12 to Marsh. Now here's the man I reckon will be a real danger in these conditions, Malcolm Marshall. Good bowler, very experienced, and he'll use his change of pace and all his variety out there, and he's still pretty pacey as well.
I think what we might find also, Richie, is that Malcolm will probably bowl with just one extra man on the onside. But I think he's thinking more about bowling straight on the stumps than bowling just outside the off stump, as is the normal. And I think that's exactly what Malcolm is talking about now, because Logie being moved from the bat pad position. Just in front of square.
Sure how long he'll do without that man in close. He could bring another one from the offside and bring him over on the onside to save the single, but it just seems to me if he's cutting the ball back to the right-handers that he might just need that man in close at short leg. Could still have the extra man on the onside, as Michael Holding pointed out before the start of the over. No ball call. No, that wasn't where it was, Malcolm. And what's more, Malcolm, you don't know where it was because you were looking down the pitch and not down to your feet. Otherwise, you'd probably have broken your leg.
I think this discussion, Richie, is just about what you just said about the bat pad and the extra man on the onside.
I think he needs the man in there. Yeah, I think that's what they're going to work on. Now, this is what Michael Holding said at first, that he will need another man in on the onside. Well, they lost the plot about halfway through out there.
Yes, definitely if you're going to be bowling straight, you need the bat pad and the extra man on the onside. And there you see Gus Logie going back into that bat pad position. And Gawn Greenidge has been moved from gully to the onside, just behind square. .339 test wickets for Malcolm Marshall. 5 wickets in an innings, 22 times, 10 wickets in a match, 4 times, averaging just about 21 runs per wicket. Very good average indeed. His best bowling, 7 for 22 against England at Old Trafford. 70 wickets against Australia so far, Malcolm Marshall, averaging just about 23.
Another no ball called. I agree with you, Malcolm, it's a stupid rule. Even more stupid law. Came in as a playing condition back in the very early 60s. And then eventually they slipped it through as a law of the game. A monument to administration.
Marshall living up to his word, bowling fairly straight, but that one just sliding down the leg side, and that's the field changes. Viv Richards moving from slip to gully.
Two or three times, and then the very, very good leg cutter. It needed an excellent catch by Geoffrey Dujon, but that was a classic piece of bowling.
Very good bowling here from Malcolm Marshall. Just doing enough to hit the edge. Very elated. Wouldn't want it thicker than that. Australia now 43 for two.
New batsman is Alan Border. Australia 2 for 43. We're in the 16th over. They're in trouble at the moment. Michael Marshall's just having a drink. Clayton Lambert has come on. Roger Harper is on the field. Everything's going in all different directions out there. But the only place Boone has gone is back to the dressing room.
Without a slip-in position, I don't think Malcolm Marshall or Geoffrey Dujon would have liked to see a thicker edge than that one.
...46 on the board, two wickets down, Taylor and Boone the men out. Taylor out for 15, Boone for two. Question out there, did he get a little inside edge? There was only a half, a sort of a throttled appeal. Might just have gone down leg side, but this fellow is bowling very well indeed. Different action. Don't often see Malcolm. I've seen him do it a couple of times when he's been playing for Hampshire.
First time I saw him do that, Richie, was in Pakistan on a very unresponsive pitch. Sort of a double action, if you might say that. Alan Border has a very big task on his shoulders here. So far, 122 test matches for Australia, just over 9,000 runs, averaging low 50s, 51 half centuries, 23 centuries. I'm sure he'll be looking to increase that to 24 in this innings. And of course, he has a highest score of 205 against New Zealand. And against the West Indies, averaging low 40s, 2 centuries, 1150s, just about 1600 runs.
Border is one of the very few batsmen in the history of the game to have made more than 5,000 runs, averaging over 50. There are others who've made 5,000 with an average under 50, others who average more but haven't yet reached the 5,000 mark. 2 for 46. Two for 51 here at Border. Jeff Marsh has strike. He has 14. Border has 6. In the commentary box now, Tony Kosier and Greg Chappell.
So Marshall in his third over. Struck in his first. Very first one for him after lunch, the second after the interval, getting Boone. As he did in the first innings, although in much more convincing fashion this time. Boone out for 2 for 51.
Malcolm Marshall looking to be enjoying his work here today. Running in like the Malcolm Marshall of old, full of enthusiasm and energy, really hitting the crease hard, hitting the pads hard pretty often too. That one, Jeffrey Marsh, pretty well forward, the ball continuing on with the angle. It's pretty hard for the umpire to give those out.
It's always easy to tell when Malcolm Marshall feels like bowling. You can read him from a mile off. Some days he comes out and he isn't in the mood, and you can tell just by one look. Today, on the contrary, as you've heard from Greg, he really does look full of enthusiasm. He bowled especially well this year in the Red Stripe Cup competition. Headed the averages, got 22 wickets in the 4 matches he played. Had a difficult time last year. Now he's calling Viv Richards down. He's really into his work here. He's thinking, he's developing policies and whispering into the ear of his captain.
Malcolm Marshall wanting to get an extra fieldsman in a catching position and close on the offside. They were trying to work out where they were coming from. That's where Vivian Richards himself has gone. He's come from out of the gully position, so he's got no catching fieldsman behind the wicket other than the wicketkeeper.
With the batsman playing forward as he is, bat and pad locked in pretty tightly together, Marshall will be looking for a little snick into the pad and the catch to Richards. This time the bat was well in behind that front pad.
If Richards is a very good fieldsman in any position, any bowler would be happy to have Vivian Richards in a catching position, in front or behind the wicket. Malcolm Marshall getting some movement in the air and off the wicket, so he's quite confident of his chances. A couple of fairly useful close-in catching fieldsmen with Vivian Richards on the offside, Gus Logie on the leg side. Gus very agile in the bat pad position. He's always on the move, trying to anticipate the direction that the ball is likely to come to him. In that position, you have a tendency to be aware of the batsman's feet. You can tell that's the first indication you as a fieldsman gets, which way the batsman's going, forward or back. And you get into the habit of trying to anticipate where the ball might go. Carl Hooper doing the fielding, coming from the deep point, the sort of one-day sweeper position. It's become a popular position in Test cricket as well, particularly on a ground like Border, which is so fast. Both captains have employed the sweeper on the offside, but Carl Hooper now coming into the circle because, well, into where the one-day circle was, because Alan Border, the left-hander, has come on strike. Malcolm Marshall now looking to go around the wicket to the left-hander. Had some success in the first innings going around the wicket. Really thinking about his bowling today, as Tony was saying, the body language from Malcolm Marshall is very strong, and he looks as though he's really keen on his work. He's thinking, he's working hard.
Two for 53 at the end of the over. Wrenched his knee a little bit in the last over going down the leg side. It isn't very often that Geoffrey Dujon has everything right physically. He's also nursing a very badly damaged finger on the right hand. Was an appeal for Marshall there, but perhaps the most significant fact was that it wasn't too far away from Richards. There was bat and pad, and that's why Richards is in the silly mid-off position. Marshall just rapping really a drum beat now on Jeff Marsh's front pad.
If I were Viv Richards, I'd be inclined to be a little bit straighter there. I have the feeling that if anything comes from bat to pad or pad to bat, it's going to come a little bit straighter, just to the right-hand side of Viv Richards there. They tend to go reasonably straight off the fast bowlers or just on the offside of the wicket generally. Still, just the mere fact that he's there is a psychological ploy as much as anything else.
He'll have to hurry at the bowler's end. Good thinking there by Greenidge. Knew he couldn't get Border, so he went to the far end. Marsh would have made it, but the experience of Greenidge.
It's a long throw from backward square leg, but a pretty good effort from Gordon Greenidge, but Geoffrey Marsh well and truly home. Alan Border was backing up and was ready to go, so there was never any danger for him at that end. And really only minimal danger for Geoffrey Marsh as well. Still good thinking from Gordon Greenidge.
Well, not a happy time for Dujon. Don't take a bye for that. Again, way down the leg side. So he's having it pretty rough, Geoffrey Dujon. No real fault of his. This pitch is bad enough at the best. Four keepers keeping low. get a ball like that to a right-arm bowler around the wicket to a left-hander means he has to be pretty well outside the off stump. Fired down the leg side, he just loses sight of it momentarily as it passes the batsman. Warning from umpire Cumberbatch to Marshall about running on the pitch. Concerted appeal, but it doesn't get the approval of umpire Cumberbatch. And we break into Malcolm Marshall with another piece from the Prime Minister's art collection. And with another single to Australia. A single there to Border, carrying him to seven. It's pretty grim stuff for Australia here. They're really battling. They've got their backs to the wall. 221, the first innings deficit. 2 for 64, plenty of time remaining. We're in the fourth day, about halfway through. And Australia have already lost the wickets of Taylor and Boone.
A little bit of movement there for Malcolm Marshall. He's hold pretty well both over and around the wicket, over the wicket to the right-hander, getting the ball to come into the right-hand batsman in the air, as he did to the left-hand batsman Alan Border towards the end of last over. Got a ball to duck in quite late. What a raucous appeal for LBW, but swinging the ball this much, particularly around the wicket to the left-hander, makes it very difficult to get an LBW appeal. Marshall had an appeal against Alan Border at the end of his last over with a ball that came in quite late, quite a bit. It's either has to have hit the stumps, it's either got to hit him from outside the off stump, which can't be out, or if it's hit him in line with the stumps, there's a very good chance it's going to miss the stumps. Indian bowlers would have enjoyed their rest day yesterday, taking it easy, knowing full well that they were going to get some work today. Saved their energy. Malcolm Marshall looks like he's saved plenty of it.
And they've come out today and found the coolest day of the match so far. It's overcast. Sun hasn't blazed down as it did in the first 3 days. There's a breeze coming across the ground. So really ideal conditions for bowling.
Could well be contributing to the fact that we've seen the ball swing more today than it has on any other day during this game. Even so, it's still quite warm. There's a nice breeze to cool things down, but fairly humid out there. Most of the batsmen, particularly with their helmets on, will be feeling the heat. Geoffrey Marsh just getting rid of some of the perspiration from under his helmet.
2 for 66 at the end of the over.
In his ninth over, 1 for 29. Batsman out for Australia. Marsh, the last man out. Bold Walsh for 22. Taylor out for 15. LBW to Ambrose. And Boone put Dujon Bold Marshall for 2. Wickets falling at 32, 43 and 67. So a monumental task now for Australia. Really going to have to bat well into the last day to save this match. Marshall has really come out firing after the break. He took over from Kirtley Ambrose. He's bowled 5 overs, 1 maiden, 1 for 11. And he's bowled extremely well in that spell. He's kept up the pressure that Ambrose had on the batsman before lunch. Courtney Walsh at fine leg. I thought, Clive, that the West Indies bowling in this innings has been much more purposeful, and there's also been much more urgency about Viv's captaincy.
Yes, well, I think Malcolm is a guy that, you know, he tends to command what sort of feel he wants. He's got that sort of confidence. The other bowlers are not that confident. But you can see that their line was much better. If you look at it, the Australians are playing across quite a lot, and it looks like if they're hit, they're very close to being at LBW. And the West Indians have got some very good conditions to bowl under here. It's a bit windy, slightly overcast, and Malcolm Marshall revels in this sort of these sort of conditions. Having played for Hampshire for quite a number of years, he's no stranger to this sort of atmosphere.
Good take by Geoffrey Dujon, a really awkward one. We've remarked often on what a great pair of hands Geoffrey Dujon's got. Very soft, and he's also a very agile wicketkeeper. Geoffrey Dujon, 35 currently. He'll 34 currently. He'll be 35 just after the series is over. So he's still very, very agile. Wicketkeeping doesn't seem to have taken too much of a toll on Geoffrey. Not an obvious one. Maybe he has a few aches and pains at night, but it doesn't show up too much on the field. Usually the knees are about the first thing that give out with the keeper.
When you're age 35, you're bordering on that period of where they call for you to be retired or to put out to grass. But Geoffrey Dujon is still doing his job. He's still fairly competent. And I presume he'd be around for another couple of tours at least.
Called a wide by umpire Cumberbatch.
That was a very sort of leg cutter that just started down the off stump and even went further away. Malcolm Marshall is getting some movement off the wicket and through the air here, and he is enjoying these conditions.
Thank you. really bowling well. Marshall, it's 3 for 71.